So that leads me to a follow-up question about this discussion about cognac and tradition. You mentioned classic. Maybe you could just talk a little bit about that and maybe its relationship with sustainability. This is something that is a project we're also working on.
That's right.
Maybe for our listeners here who might be watching this, to just to give a little breakdown of what that means.
Yeah, so that's a very interesting question because we're actually working on this right now. And it's sort of crazy because I didn't think about that. So let me think out loud on this subject because we are looking for a product who have extended the longevity of the product using elements, classic elements, in order to generate this longevity. And therefore, our research question is, do classic elements improve the longevity of products and therefore make them more sustainable? Mm-hmm. And that's what we think. And that's what we're starting to see by actually collecting information. Yep. And it's true that if we were to look at cognac, and probably we should, we can actually see that with cognac, the classic elements are very important. So classic elements in cognac.
For instance, the bottle.
So the bottle is one of them. The label is one of them. Yeah. The message is one of them. But even the taste, I would say, is one of them.
Right.
So there is sort of a classic cognac taste. And this classic cognac taste, I think, is very good because it's something that you would want to something that you would expect from cognac, but you have to be very careful. So the classic elements of cognac is it tends to be sweeter.
Yeah.
You know, so it's a spirit that is sweet by nature because it's a fruit spirit. It's aged in barrels, which may be delivering some sweet notes. The sweetness is therefore a classic element of cognac. They would be looked at within the spirits world as being more sweet. Another thing that people will look at is the darker color. So if you look at quality whiskey and if you look at quality cognacs, you will see that the cognacs are far more darker. Without going into so much details about it, there is a reason. Is because the darkness is also perceived as a classic element. Another thing is you would have some flavor that tends to be classic, like the caramel. So people think about this flavor of caramel, this flavor of vanilla, as being also classic elements. In the smell, is you would imagine that there's some classic aromas such as apricot or vanilla, or some like more flower, like a bouquet, like a cluster of flowers, freshness type of aroma. So these are classic. The brand that would have these elements would be considered classic. And I think people that are used to cognac would probably think these are smooth, and they would say smooth, velvety, sweet, and lingering. And then there's another one that I forgot to mention because I personally try to stay away from it. It's like an oak flavor, you know, some kind of oakiness, smokiness. Yeah. In cognac, smokiness is not a classic element, but oakiness is a classic element. Smokiness is more an element that you would find from scotch, for example, as a classic element, and within various degree, from very little to huge amount of smokiness, if you're actually tasting a peated whiskey. For cognac, you will find more elements of oakiness. So unfortunately, those classic characteristics of cognacs are sometimes pushed to the extreme. It's almost like, you know, the oakiness is so overwhelming, the sweetness is so overwhelming, the darkness and the vanilla and the caramel flavors sometimes are so overwhelming that one has to wonder, how could they be? So supposedly there's some blending that where they're trying to blend everything in order to emphasize those notes. But these notes are classic, so somewhat expected in cognac. Not all cognac have these classic notes, but one could imagine that that these notes are enhancing the classic features of the cognac and therefore making this company more likely to be successful. Then in the presentation, I think it's very important to look at the fact that there's two elements that really work for cognac. One is an element of tradition, using traditional expected features for the presentation. And then the other one is elements of luxury, perceived luxury. So they will use a lot of gold, a lot of sort of regal colors like red, not too bright red, but like a rich red, a rich blue, anything. So there's always this concept of it has to be looking luxurious for cognac. So I think making a cognac that doesn't have its features can be successful, but then you need to have a cognac that looks very traditional. And again, what I'm saying is a general comment. There's always some exceptions of some cognacs that are somewhat successful and not having these, but that would be the 1%. So the 99% is very much having an older looking font, older looking label that would look like it could be aged. It's going to be ornate. They're pretty decorated. They are. They don't promote very much the label as if it was hand written on it and all these things. So this, or if it was hand written, it would have to be handwriting. It would have to be done in a fashion that it enhanced the authenticity and the tradition. So it is very difficult to innovate in terms of presentation. And so there's a lot of innovation now in the added features that they would give you like a wax insignia. And that used to be so expensive that you had to order 40,000 of them. But now with technology, they are able to make 5,000 of them for the same price as it used to be for 40,000. So then you benefit from those features, having a wax sign, having some engraving. So all the technology is enhancing all the packaging, but for the sake of making it more luxurious, or for the sake of making it look more old, more traditional. And that's all these elements, classic elements that I think are important in the cognac industry.